of all those children of Mary and Joseph. Because Jesus Christ have brothers and sisters in the flesh, born of Mary and Joseph. That's why when the Jews saw him, they marveled at him. This man have not learned from schools. Why do he know letters? Is this not the carpenter? The son of Mary? The brother of James and Joseph? And it is wonderful to note something in this verse, Brother Joseph.
What is that, Brother?
Is not this the carpenter? The son of Mary? Joseph was not anymore around when the Lord Jesus Christ was preaching. He is resting already.
Oh.
That's why the trade of being the carpenter was labeled unto him, not to Joseph anymore, who is the original carpenter, his foster father. He's the original carpenter. But inasmuch as Joseph was already, at that time, is dead already, the information is very clear. According to the Jews, is this not the carpenter, the son of Mary? They did not mention the son of, as they know, Jesus Christ was the son of Joseph,
yes.
You see? But they did not mention Joseph anymore because Joseph was already dead by that time as a caring father, Brother Joseph. If Joseph was alive then Joseph must be with Jesus in the cross. But he was not anymore around that time when he died. 3 years later, when he started the ministry, 3 years later, Jesus Christ was crucified. And from the start of his ministry until the end of his three-year ministry on earth, Joseph was not anymore around. He had already rested. He was already dead. That's why the label of being a carpenter was put unto Jesus. Is this not the carpenter, the son of Mary, the brother of James, Joseph, Judah, and Simon? And are not his sisters here with us? They were offended at him. What is our point here, Brother Joseph? Jesus Christ was not gone all those 12 years or 18 years, as others claim, from 12 to 30. He was very much seen by the Jews. He was seen as the carpenter, acting as the carpenter, continuing the trade of his father, being a carpenter.
Amen.
He was there. And at age 30, he preached, not attending any school at any time. And they marveled, how can he know letter when he did not study at any time? Having never learned, the Jews said, because they have seen Jesus, not a day carrying a pencil and a notebook going to school. No. They have never seen him study. So my point is, it is not necessary for a preacher to be educated. What is necessary is a preacher be sent.
Amen.
Not being educated by the standards of this world or by the schools and learning institutions of this world. In fact, most of his apostles are also not educated people, like the fisherman Simon, which is Peter, and John, and James. They are not educated people. They are not learned. So if you are going to look for a preacher sent by God, you do not look for a diploma. I don't have any. Brother Joseph.
Yes, Brother Eli.
I'm saying this not to boast of what I am. I'm saying this to humble myself and to humiliate myself to everybody. I'm saying this by faith, that it is not necessary for a preacher to be sent by God that you have to study in human institutions of learning. Now, but although I say that I have no diploma whatsoever, I have learned what I have known from my professor. And my professor is the Lord Jesus Christ, Brother Joseph. As he said in the book of Matthew chapter 11, let us read.
Come unto me, all ye that labor and are heavy laden, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you.
And learn of me. We have to learn from Jesus. As Peter and John learned from Jesus, And they marveled at them. 4:13, let us go back to that verse. This is the only program that repeats verses of the Bible.
Now, when they saw the boldness of Peter and John and perceived that they were unlearned and ignorant men, they marveled, and they took knowledge of them that they had been with Jesus.
That is clear. They were unlearned, but they have been with Jesus. Why? Jesus, the greatest professor after all.
Amen.
Now, our topic is concerning the preacher, Brother Joseph.
Yes, Brother Eli.
Because there are four necessary things we must understand for regarding salvation. There must be a preacher sent by God, then the word of God, the ability to hear, and the spirit that will open the understanding of a person that heareth the word of God. Now, our topic is about the preacher. We are not yet through. It is just an introduction of what a preacher must be. First, he must be sent by God. He is sent by God not to do miracles.
Oh, yes.
But to speak the word of God. Miracles are only sideways considering the highways. Huh? It is not the main function of the preacher to do miracles, but to preach. That is one thing we have to warn our listeners about. Because there are now preachers whose main function is to perform miracles in order to convert, to
attract people.
Beware, brothers and sisters. This is a scheme of the devil so that he will be deceived. Let us read 24:24 of the book of Matthew.
For there shall arise false Christs and false prophets, and they shall show great signs and wonders, insomuch that, if it were possible, they shall deceive the very elect.
That is clear. That is clear to false Christ and false prophets. Their main attraction of their show is the showing of signs and wonders. A preacher of God, although the apostles can perform miracles, that is not their main function, according to Paul. Let us read in the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 9:16.
For though I preach the gospel, I have nothing to glory of, for necessity is laid upon me. Yea, woe is unto me if I preach not the gospel.
So the highway of somebody sent by God, his highway that he must travel, is to preach the gospel. Amen. It is not doing miracles and signs and wonders. That is the main and the focal point of the deceivers who are the Antichrist, the false Christ, and the false prophets. To show great signs and wonders as a mean to attract people. But somebody sent by God must preach the gospel. You see? The Apostle Paul, though I preach the gospel, he said, I have nothing to glory of. For necessity is laid upon me. What is the necessary thing for a preacher to do, Brother Joseph?
To preach, Brother Eli.
To preach. But how will they preach if they are not sent? The question is answered. In order to preach, you have to be first sent by God. Whether the teaching of God may be bitter or sour or sugary or sweet, you have to accept all the teachings of Christ, incorporate them in your being, and you will be saved.
Listen as Brother Eli teaches the true doctrines of our Lord Jesus Christ, unadulterated, unparalleled.
If we love God, we will obey His commandments. We will not just listen to the commandments and let it go. No, if we really love God, we have to obey His commandments.
We invite everyone to our ongoing mass indoctrination. Visit us at L123 Paracu Estate, Anivom Court, Community 15, Sakumono Tema, Ghana, Africa. Or at number 200/6, Apia Junction, Kaswa, Central Region, Ghana, Africa. For inquiries, you may call us or send us an email.